would be a damn fool to argue with people who defend Fury after the bullshit that he's been pulling all this time. The cheating's right in front of people's faces, but they deny that. They're going to deny everything. If they deny the glove, they're going to deny this COVID thing. They're going to deny the Klitschko, you know, rematch cheating out of that, you know. They're going to deny the steroids that he used. They're going to deny everything Fury does, you know. Fury has that hope card. So Fury could literally commit murder on fucking video and they will still deny it. My point is this. Stop talking about the Fury Wilder fight with these Fury fans until you actually see him in the ring. Don't give them your energy. They've had enough of your energy already. This just allows them to continue to say things about Wilder and all this and all that. Don't deal with beta males like them, man. Don't even say nothing more about this until Fury gets the balls to fight. We know the truth. Ain't no point in even arguing with them about it. In fact, they know the truth. The truth hurts. That's why they still, only thing they could come up with is Wilder-esque or something about Wilder. Notice they don't say nothing about why Fury is fully vaccinated and still has COVID. You know, and all the dislikes that I'm going to get on this video is probably them. Because I'm not saying nothing but the truth. But this time, I'm going to let this video ride. I don't care about the dislikes. It just proves that he cheated and he can't cheat again. He's trying to find a way to throw Wilder off and find a way to cheat. You know what I mean? It's sad, man. The grown-ass man who talks all that stuff about he can beat somebody with one hand tied behind his back. You know, you have to cheat. You have to make excuses for fights and all this stuff, man. If Fury was my skin complexion, a lot of those people who are arguing with y'all over what he has done, you know, the cheating and everything, they wouldn't. But you know how it goes. So if I was y'all, it ain't even about being a Wilder fan. It's about the truth. If I was y'all, I wouldn't even get on these social medias and argue with these people. They're going to defend him no matter what. If they defended him for the gloves flapping around everywhere and for them cutting off the camera, you know, to do whatever they did with the gloves, these people are going to defend him no matter what because they really hate Wilder, you know. And some of them hate the truth. They're the type of guy that gets cheated on by his girlfriend and sees it right in his bedroom in his house and they still deny it. They still give her an excuse way out of maybe she didn't do it and all this stuff, man. They just want to argue with y'all. Don't let them steal your energy. You know what I mean? Don't even worry about it. Don't talk about this stuff no more until you see Fury in the ring. Until then, we already know what time it is. We don't need to prove them anything. They know the truth. They're just not going to tell you that because they need that. They want to argue with you. See, misery loves company. So now that they know the truth, Fury fans, that is, and they feel sad about it or upset about it or a certain way about it, they want you to feel a certain way still. So the only way is to basically keep arguments of a lie. It's no different than Floyd beating Pacquiao. And if Pacquiao beats Spence, he's better than Floyd. You know, these people are just trying to keep up a argument lie because deep down they're miserable because Floyd beat Pacquiao. And they want you to feel that way. And the only way they can make you feel that way is argue about lies. You know, like lies like, Fury is not scared of Wilder. And it's obvious by now. Or lies about Pacquiao's better than Floyd, even though Floyd beat him. Ooh, Floyd cheated. Floyd did this. Floyd did that. Anything to make you join the misery of Floyd beating Pacquiao. So now you got the anything to make you join the misery of Fury actually cheated in the Wilder fight. It's proof now. If he didn't, he would have took the fight and he would beat Wilder again. So easy, right? He can beat Wilder so easy. Why don't he just fight? Why do you need steroids? Nothing to argue about. I don't waste my time with them people no more, man. Because I see that they're not really bringing forth legitimate arguments. They're just arguing with their feelings and then bias. So what's the point, right? No matter what happens. It's just like a person killing a cop and you know it was racially motivated, but they're going to say that, oh, no, that's not it. That's not why he was doing this or that. Don't argue with people like this, man. They need you to join their misery. They're not in tune with reality. Don't argue with people like this, man. It doesn't change the fact that he did what he did, and he's not going to hide from God. Even if he never fights fury, still got to fight that battle with God. If you cheated and loaded your gloves and tried to basically murder a man in a ring, yeah, you might not fight Wilder again, but you can't hide from God. God knows what you did, so it don't matter. And God is going to do worse than Wilder could ever do, so it doesn't even matter. You'll see. It will be put right in front of you in front row HD, dude. Can't do things like that and get away with them. So there's no need for you to argue with these fans who know the truth, but they just want y'all to join their misery because reality is setting in on them that he actually did cheat. They seen the gloves. They seen the camera cut off. They seen the guy about to expose him for the cow meat. They seen him pull out the Klitschko fight and all these other things. They seen him get suspended for steroids instead of drug abuse like he claimed. You know, now it's COVID. Motherfucker might have pissed dirty again. Who knows? Ain't no telling. But anyways, who would defend somebody that makes people pay all this money to get rooms and stuff for Vegas for a fight and this guy calls out, pulls out because he says he has COVID? Y'all defend somebody like that? These people then lost money over a coward. Fully vaccinated, but he got COVID now. And even if he did, it only takes 2 weeks. But see, you can be Wilder with one hand tied behind your back. So what's the COVID? Love exposing the truth to these motherfuckers. Fake. If you can beat Wilder with one hand tied behind your back, what's the COVID? The judge should order him to prove that he has COVID. All these people paid all this money to get these rooms and everything, and this dude's pulling out again. I knew he would do it. But he can't hide from God. Fury cannot hide from God. If he cheated, which I'm sure he did, look at the tape. And now it's blatantly obvious. Can't hide from God, Fury. You see this video? Remember, you don't gotta fight Wilder again, but the fight with God's gonna be worse because of what you did, man. You know what you did. And the sad part is you didn't have to cheat. You could have beat him without cheating, but you chose the cowardly route. And his fans are going to say he didn't cheat and this and this. These are the same people that will say he didn't kill that guy because of his race. Dude didn't even have nothing on him. Oh, that's not because of his race. It's the same people. Don't deal with trash-ass people like this, man. They're cowards. They don't deal with reality. They don't operate in reality. They're like females. They operate in feelings, not reality. Don't deal with men like this because they're not real men. Any real man would want the truth and accept the truth and honor the truth, not the lies. Not the lies. Say Wilder made excuses up all you want, but the cow meat, that's one excuse for using steroids. I can't fight Klitschko again, my ankle, that's another excuse. I can't fight Wilder, the COVID, that's another excuse. I got suspended for or drug abuse, but it really was steroids, that's another excuse. We can go on and on with all the gloves. I don't know. They was just loose on my hand and this and this. I cut off the camera for this and this. All these excuses. But, you know, he got that hope card. In other words, he can do things and get away with it because of what he looks like. We know this. And it's okay. Because guess what? God knows this. Even if things aren't fair on earth, there's a God. There's a higher power that will make things fair regardless. In the end, it will catch up with people. It's a sad shame that all these people paid all this money for this fight and this dude pulled this stuff again, and you still have cowardly ass men defending that. It ain't even about Wilder or anymore. It's about Fury now. How about that? Why is it when Fury does something, it always focuses back on what Wilder did and said? Wilder's not stopping this fight. Apparently, you motherfuckers don't want to see the fight because you know what's going to happen. So the only straw you can reach for is stuff that already in the past, a soup or some dumb shit like that. You know what time it is. I know what time it is. And y'all know what time it is. Don't deal with these fake people, man. They're a disgrace, man. It's a sad shame, but it is what it is, man. Don't don't give them their energy. Talk about some other fights or something. Whenever they bring up Fury and all that, don't even say nothing about Fury being scared or none of that. They know what time it is. There's no point in giving your energy to these people who don't deal with the truth. They deal with illusions like women. You know, they deal with what feels good to them, not the truth. And that's facts, man. I'm out of here.